beautiful people. Today's video is about how to create a double exposure in Photoshop. I am not a professional in Photoshop, but what I'm doing is trial and error. Through this, I learned and developed my skills in this field. So let's learn together and discover the tools to create double exposure. Let's start. First, open the photo of the model in Photoshop. Then, do a selection. You can use different selection methods that you are comfortable with. In this video, I am using subject selection. Once the subject is already selected, go to Select menu and click Modify and select Expand to adjust the pixel selection and enter 0.5 pixels. Then, click the mask symbol located at the bottom part of the layer, as I've illustrated on the screen. So now, you can delete the mask by dragging it to the trash bin icon. This time, you have to add solid colors and set it to white, and don't forget to click the OK button. Then, drag the color field below the layer. You can rename the layers in order for you not to get confused later. Locate the photo you want to use to create the double exposure. You can click File and place Embedded or Linked. You can also drag and drop the second photo over the photo of the model. To adjust the landscape photo with the photo of the model, you can adjust the opacity to 50% in order for you to see clearly and adjust them accordingly. Once you finish the adjustment, you have to put back the opacity back to 100%. This time, reselect a model and make sure you select the landscape tool layer before you click the mask. Copy the model layer by clicking the Alt in Windows or Option in Mac and drag it above the landscape layer. Make sure you select a model copying layer and change the appearance from normal to lighten and change the opacity to 50% or less. Then, click Mask icon. Here, click the Brush tool and make sure the foreground color is black. Also, set the flow to 40% or less. Now, you can start to paint the area you want to appear the part of the landscape over the photo of the model. Do the same thing with the landscape layer. Once you selected the landscape layer and use the Brush tool, this is the opposite thing. You will make the face of the model visible over the landscape photo. Select a BG layer and double-click the BG layer to open the color picker and use the dropper and select the brightest area of the landscape photo and click OK button to save your selection. The next step is to duplicate the landscape layer. You can use the shortcut Ctrl-J in Windows or Command-J in Mac and delete the mask of the landscape copy by dragging and drop the mask to the trash bin icon. Then, change from normal to lighten. Finally, we created the double exposure. From here, you can adjust or tweak the curves, level, vibrance, and etc. It depends on your preference or taste. As I said before, enjoy learning by doing trial and error. This is the before photo. This is the after photo with the double exposure. Hope this short video is useful to you and please support our channel by subscribing to it. If you have some clarifications and subject you want me to tackle, please leave your comment below. Thank you. If you have knowledge, let others light their candles at it. Have a blessed Sunday, everyone.